fascinating example, fascinating to me anyway. The hero of Joyce's Ulysses, Leopold Bloom. Critics refer to Bloom as a Jew from the 1920s up until the 1970s when somebody published an essay in the James Joyce Review called "Is Leopold Bloom a Jew?" It depends on how you define Jew. According to the rabbinical definition, a Jew is the son of a Jewish mother. Bloom is not Jewish by that definition. He's the son of a Protestant mother. According to the Nazi definition, a Jew is anybody with a known Jewish ancestor. Bloom is a Jew by that definition because his father was Jewish. A third definition is a Jew is somebody who practices the Jewish religion. By that definition, almost every Jew I know is not a Jew. I don't know a single Jew who practices the religion. And Leopold Bloom doesn't practice the religion either. So he's not a Jew by that definition. Fourth definition is somebody who, even though he doesn't practice the religion and doesn't have a Jewish mother, regards himself as Jewish because of ethnic or cultural solidarity. And then there's a fifth category, which is somebody who doesn't generally think of himself as Jewish, but suddenly finds himself identified that way or identifying himself that way, like Dreyfus, perhaps, when he denounced some of Israel's foreign policies. I don't think he generally thinks of himself as Jewish, but he had to think of himself as Jewish when he was criticizing Israel. So is Leopold Bloom a Jew? The answer turns out by three definitions he isn't, and by two definitions he is. And is this trivial? I don't think so. I think Joyce made Bloom's background genetically and culturally so complicated to make anti-Semitism seem even more ridiculous. Because Bloom is only Jewish by some definitions. Yet the anti-Semites that Bloom encounters during the long day of Ulysses, they all treat him as if they know what a Jew is and that Bloom fits their definition. Hardly any of them know he doesn't practice the Jewish religion, for instance. As a matter of fact, Bloom is officially a Catholic, although he doesn't practice that religion either, but he converted in order to marry Molly.
So you're saying that the words that we use are often reductive to the point of actually warping the situation?
Yeah, well, I think almost all forms of group prejudice, group bias, group hatred, group violence are all, I think they're all either caused by or vastly exacerbated by the use of labels with pejorative connotations.